So why did Little Sunshines choose the Reggio Emilia approach? In the first video, you learned the basics of Reggio, the who, what, when, and where. If you haven't seen it, we provided a link in the comments below. In this video, we want to tell you about why we chose this educational approach. Why do we use a Reggio-inspired curriculum at Little Sunshines? Why is it different than any other curriculum offered? We have a lot to cover, so let's jump in. So why did we choose Reggio? When founder and CEO Roche Daler began Little Sunshines in her home in 2002, she discovered that her students thrived and retained knowledge through exploration, nature, imagination, and student-led activities. She was so inspired by her students' process of learning that she began to research approaches with these fundamentals in mind. She quickly discovered that she actually had been facilitating learning through the Reggio Emilia approach. This is how it all began. Why Reggio is different than any other curriculum? As we discovered in the last video, there are many unique qualities that set the Reggio Emilia philosophy apart from other curriculum being offered to early learners. These differences are the core principles of the approach. Let's do a quick recap. 1. The first principle that sets Reggio apart from other curriculum is the belief that children are capable of constructing their own learning. 2. Children form an understanding of themselves and their place in the world through their interactions with others. As educators, we put a strong emphasis on social collaboration and working in groups where each child is an equal participant, having their thoughts, questions, and interests valued. 3. The belief that children are communicators. Communication should be viewed as a process, a way of discovering things by asking questions or using language as play. Children are encouraged to use language to investigate and explore, to reflect on their experiences. They should be listened to with respect, believing their questions and observations are an opportunity to learn and search together. 4. The environment is the third teacher. The environment is recognized for its potential to inspire children. Remember, no two Reggio-inspired communities should look the same, as the needs and interests of each classroom within the school will be different. Our teachers are creative and design their classrooms around the students. 5. The adult is a mentor and guide. As the education facilitator, our purpose is to observe our students, listen to them, and discover what interests them, what engages them. Base our curriculum activities off these interactions and observations. For example, if we observe our students throwing toys, we consider it to be a great opportunity to create an engaging and educational game that requires them to throw something into a basket. 6. An emphasis on documenting children's thoughts. Documentation should make the learning visible to its audience by providing evidence of the children's learning in all areas of the child's development. Through artwork, pictures, and drawings, we can see the learning process. Making learning visible through documentation provides us more information about our students' learning and progress that may not be evident in a checklist or assessment. Why is the classroom considered the third teacher? The Reggio Emilia approach is focused on community, exploration, and collaboration. Because of this, we create an environment that is cultivated on being welcoming and authentic. How do we ensure our classroom is welcoming and authentic? It's simple. We view our classroom as a living organism, then self-reflect on how we are creating an environment that is inclusive of each child while creating a social and emotional environment of community. A healthy classroom will have signs of collaboration, student-led projects, friendships, laughter, excitement, focus, and curiosity. In addition to the social and emotional aspect of a welcoming and authentic environment, we also self-reflect on the physical and aesthetic beauty of our classroom, constantly asking ourselves, does our classroom aesthetically say, "Welcome to our community"? We set up our classroom as a welcoming environment. We make sure open-ended items or loose parts are clean, presentable, and nicely arranged to invite children to discover and explore. The classroom is well thought out to cultivate the interest of our students and to create the feel and understanding of community. Why do we use monthly curriculum themes? We use monthly themes to help cultivate developmentally appropriate topics for teachers. Each theme is carefully picked for each month. Though the themes are broad and allow us to cater to the interest of our students, it is nice to have a cohesive theme across our schools nationwide. We have fun with these themes and use them to spark interest in our classroom. We love taking our students' interests and turning them into art projects that inspires more questions and more engaging conversations that leads to another art project or perhaps an outdoor activity. Why children love Reggio curriculum. Well, who doesn't like to be in charge? So often, children are told what to do, how to act, what they will learn, and when they will learn it in traditional schools. With Reggio, the child or student is allowed to explore and develop their education according to their interests, since teachers are considered collaborators with children. Plus, activities are hands-on and provide experiences through exploration. The Reggio approach also focuses on the social and emotional aspects of learning to help create community. The child has a say-so in what and how they learn, which helps create a lifelong love of learning. Why parents like you love Reggio curriculum? In sum, all parents want their children to be cared for and taught. But over time, we've realized there are several things about Reggio that parents love. Parents love that the philosophy has a strong focus on social and emotional development. As young children grow, they experience new and different emotions, usually in social settings. They need adult guidance and support to help them understand these feelings and navigate them, becoming more independent from their parents as they build friendships and develop a desire to be around children their age. In Reggio terms, this is known as developing and nurturing the whole child. 2. Learning through play gets their children excited about learning. And when their kids are excited about learning, they want to learn more and more often. What's not to love about that? Parent and teacher engagement and building a community. Parents love hearing feedback and ideas from their child's teachers or caregivers. This process is not only valuable to moms and dads, it's critical in creating a positive and productive learning environment for your students. Last but not least, parents love the emphasis on nature and creativity. In Reggio, instead of explaining concepts and ideas, we let students explore them. Elements of nature are brought into the learning environment or classrooms, and an effort is also made to go out into nature every day, allowing them to explore and learn in different environments. Changing environments such as indoor to outdoor, or even learning centers, keeps children engaged and allows them to learn in different ways. Have you taken an activity outside lately? Why are loose parts important to the implementation of Reggio? Have you ever noticed how after young children open a gift, they put the toy down and play with a wrapping paper or box? Everyone laughs and comments, right? It's pretty funny, but actually, this is an example of loose parts and the important role they play in a child's creative and imaginative play. Some of you may be asking, what are loose parts? Loose parts are both natural and manufactured items that can be moved, combined, and taken apart in several ways. The natural elements can include wood, rocks, pine cones, shells, sticks, leaves, and several other materials that can be found outside. Some examples of manufactured materials include blocks, balls, and boxes. Using a variety of these materials in your classroom not only encourages creativity, but leads to engaged learning, therefore fostering a love of learning. Let's take a closer look at why we think loose parts are important. Loose parts play not only encourages imagination, cooperation, and interaction among their peers, but it also develops problem-solving skills and promotes learning in subjects like math and science. Loose parts also encourages open-ended play. Playing with open-ended materials allow for play with endless possibilities. On the other hand, activities that are closed-ended have a given outcome or right answer, like a puzzle. This type of play can restrict creativity and imagination. Hopefully you've learned a lot about Reggio Emilia watching this video. I encourage you to ask your school leadership and experienced teachers lots of questions. If you're the one providing educational care, I encourage you to continuously explore and try new ideas. I will leave you with this quote from Loris Malaguzzi, founder and creator of Reggio Emilia. The Reggio system can be described succinctly as follows. It is a collection of schools for young children in which each child's intellectual, emotional, social, and moral potentials are carefully cultivated and guided. The principal educational vehicle involves youngsters in long-term engrossing projects, which are carried out in a beautiful, healthy, love-filled setting. To watch our video on how to implement Reggio Emilia-inspired learning, click the link in the comments. If you like this video and want to receive alert for future videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button below.